Welcome to Recombu, it's Basil here. I have the Sony Xperia Z Ultra in my hands. The Xperia Z Ultra was the device we took a look at last week, but we didn't quite get a chance to properly play with it the way we wanted to. As you can see, we've thrown a bunch of applications on there, benchmarked the phone to high heavens, and we can report it is indeed a monster. The 6.4 inch display isn't the only reason it's a monster, although that makes a good starting point. The triluminous display technology means you're gonna get really, really gorgeous, vibrant colors. Full HD resolution gives it a very respectable PPI, meaning that Sony has finally shaken off the stigma attached with its screens after the Xperia Z. Viewing angles are great, head on, it looks fantastic, so bravo, Sony. As far as the rest of the design goes, and this thing is big, there is no getting around that. In fact, if we pull an HTC One into frame, the Sony Xperia Z, into frame, we can see that the two devices just, it makes the 5-inch phone look absolutely minuscule, with 5 inches being on the bigger side of what we'd expect to see from flagships now. Really, this thing isn't going to appeal to the mainstream, let's face it. But it is impressive, Sony are taking some leaps, and it is also waterproof and dust resistant. All the ports are underneath flaps, except for the 3.5mm headphone jack on the right hand side. What ports are they? That includes a micro SD card and a micro SIM tray, as well as a micro USB port for data and charging. The 3.5mm headphone jack is in an awkward position in the top right, but with a phone this big, we're going to expect you to use a Bluetooth headset, such as the one that's going to come out alongside it when it's released. Think it's the SBH52. The Sony Xperia Z Ultra unfortunately doesn't pack a camera flash, but it does pack a very capable 8-megapixel rear-facing camera. The camera UI is the same Sony UI that we have come to know and love from the Xperia Z. This includes a whole host of shooting modes, as well as a superior auto mode that makes a whole load of decisions for you. You can tweak a few settings in this mode, but chances are it'll make the right decisions 9 times out of 10. What everyone's really keen to see is the processing power in this thing, and with its quad-core Qualcomm Snapdragon 800 processor, even the most intensive games like Nova 3 run absolutely beautifully. Smoke, particle effects, you've got everything on there, including blur. It's just a really, really nice user experience altogether. It goes without saying, HD movies are going to be amazing on this thing. A completely immersive experience if you can handle carrying around a plus 6-inch phone with you. Is it a realistic size for a phone? Well, it's too early to say. Until we get one in the office, we really can't make a judgment call on that. But one thing is for sure, it is a testament to the fact that Sony can indeed be at the cutting edge of technology. With its 3000 milliamp battery, it should also last for a while. Maybe not quite a full day given our first impressions, although this is pre-production prototype software. Plus, Sony does pack some really cool power management modes such as Power Stamina, which turns off applications and mobile data when the screen's off unless you override it. So that's been our second first impression of the Sony Xperia Z Ultra. Hope you've enjoyed this more in-depth look. If you have any questions, please let us know. I've been Basil, this has been Recombu. If you like this video, click like, and if you like our channel, just click subscribe.